Hey everyone, thank you for being here and tuning in. We're going to continue our CBF Presents, and today's guest teacher and a friend of mine, her name is Lizelle. She is from South Africa, and she'll be teaching you guys how to paint with oils and acrylics together. This will be a great video for those of you wanting to experiment with oils, and also all the materials she uses, there will be everything down below in the description for you guys. And check her out, check out her Instagram, check out her social media platforms. I'll put her name right here and give her some love. I'm excited to have her on board. Also, be sure to use hashtag ColorByFeliks so that we can see your recreations and share them with my community. All right guys, enjoy the lesson.
Hello everybody! So let's start with some introductions. I'm Lizelle Strivig, I'm a South African oil painter, and I've been asked here today to do this tutorial with you guys. I'm very honored. This is my very first ever tutorial or video, so please just bear with me. We're gonna do this beautiful night scene on a 16 by 16 inch stretch canvas with some starry night reflecting into the water. Then in front we're gonna have just two beautiful palm trees. That's going to be our focal point, and just some mountains at the back. The reason I chose to do this as my first tutorial is because a few months ago I did this ship at sea with a starry night, and I got a lot of questions on how I did the sky and what colors I use. So I thought this was the best opportunity to show you guys how I did the sky, and also I had extremely fun. I really enjoyed painting that sky, so we're gonna do this today. We're gonna need a few things. We're gonna need three glass containers, with two with turpentine, one with clean turpentine, one with where you can clean your brushes in, and then just another container that you can pour in some water into for the acrylic paint we're going to use. Then we're going to need some turpentine, obviously water, and we're also going to need some paper towels or just a old towel you can use to wipe your brushes. Then we're going to need any palette. I'm going to use this tear off paper palette. I usually work on a piece of glass to mix my paint, but I thought for the tutorial this paper palette will be better. Then we're also going to need a few brushes. We're going to use a big brush. This is a number 12 flat round brush. This is for some bigger areas, so if you want to use a bigger brush, use a bigger brush. About the same size, but an overused old fluffy brush. This is very nice to blend out your paint when we're moving on to the oil paints. Then also again, another old overused fluffy brush. This is going to be for dry brushing. So also very soft brush. Then also another one, also overused brush, very smaller, because this is going to be for the stars. I think that's about a 4, not sure. Then we're going to need this two angled brushes. I think it's a quart and a half. Just two sizes, it doesn't really matter. And lastly, we're going to use this small round brush. This is a number 4. We're going to use it for the palm trees in front. Then moving on to a palette knife, you can use any palette knife you prefer. This is my favorite palette knife. I use it to mix all my paints. It works very nicely, but you can use any one you prefer. We're also going to use it for the mountains, so just be sure not to go too big with the palette knife. Then moving on to some paints. Firstly, we're going to have this, I think it's Palo Blue, I'm not sure how to pronounce it. Then Cadmium Red, just normal Cadmium Red. These two you're also going to need in acrylic, because we're going to do just some other painting with the acrylic paints. Then you're going to need some Titanium White. Also, you're going to need Titanium White in acrylic. And some Lamp Black. Then we're going to need chrome yellow. You can also use cadmium yellow pale hue. Some sap green for the trees, obviously. And then we're going to use French ultramarine blue and some burnt sienna. Those two colors we're going to mix to get a very dark, almost black color. And then lastly, we are going to use yellow ochre. And that's it. So, I have already mixed a few colors. This is just the polo blue and the cadmium red in different ratios, and the lighter colors have just a tiny little bit of white. I find it difficult to mix the paint in the air, so I just pre-mixed it. But the ratio is about, it's different ratios, but it's about 60-40, and then the more purpley one has just got a little bit more of red. You're gonna start with your darkest color at the top. You're gonna start with the darkest color, and then we're gonna move to your more lighter colors. But we're not gonna do the whole sky because this is acrylic. I normally do this in oil paints as well, but I really want this to dry quickly, so I'm gonna have to do this in acrylic. You can do it in oil paints, you're just gonna have to wait for a drying period of a day or two. I really just wanted to do this in one sitting, so I needed to do this in acrylic paint. So we're just gonna cover it very nicely. So you just keep going. Just gonna try and smooth it out also a little bit more. Also, you don't have to do this painting in oils. If you want to do it in acrylic, you are more familiar with acrylic paints, then just do it with acrylic paints. Just gonna smooth it out a little bit. Just gonna add a little bit more of white. So just roughly blend it out. I'm just going to make sure that I covered all the areas. I have some extra paint, so just gonna do some reflection here. Okay, so we're going to add some water to the white. We're going to use this old kindergarten trick to splatter on some stars. Going to use your finger. This is going to be the Milky Way. So the acrylic is a lot more transparent than I'm used to with the oils, so you're gonna have to go over a few times. doesn't have to be perfect. Take this as a practice round. So we're just gonna do this whole Milky Way. Also, as you can see, I twist and turn my brush on my hands so it goes different directions. Just have control over your brush and where the stars and the splatters will go. spreading some stars out across the whole sky. So moving on to the oil paints, we have our already mixed sky color, but I will be moving on to the mountains by mixing my own black color with ultramarine brown burnt sienna. Just a quick tip, you can skip this step and wait till we get back to the sky and then just later come back to the mountains. So we're just mixing our black here. It's 50% ultramarine blue and 50% burnt sienna. And as you can see, it's quite black. And for this, we are going to use angular brushes. We're going to thin the paint with just a tiny little bit of turpentine, so we will be able to paint easier, because this is just roughly is just a first layer of the mountains. The thinner your paint will be, the straighter lines you will be able to paint. We're gonna do just a quick layer of the mountains and also the reflection of the mountains in the water. So now we're going to move on to the sky. I'm gonna need some few new colors for that. I'm just quickly going to, this is the polo blue. We're just gonna add some white. We're gonna make two shades, one darker color and then a lot lighter color. Gonna mix an orange, some yellow and orange, yellow and red, about 50-50 to make a nice orange. If you have orange, you don't have to mix it, you can just use the orange. I thought I would just mix it for those who don't have orange. Okay, now we have our orange, we're gonna add some white. I'm gonna make probably two or three different shades of orange. Just gonna get more white. Now we're gonna just add some more white for another lighter orange. And then just a more yellowish, light yellowish color. We're gonna take some white over here and a tiny little bit of red. We're gonna make a like a pinkish color, but very light. So just be careful for too much red. And then we're just gonna take that exact color, mixing a little bit of purple, but a lighter purple, a very light purple. Just gonna take some of those previously mixed blue, some red and white to mix a light purple color. Like that. Okay, we're gonna start with some white. We're gonna go as close as you can to the mountains. If you did the mountains, just be careful because you might smudge it. And use the angled brush they work best for close areas. Just gonna go all around the mountains. As you can see, I am already smudging. Just gonna try and fix the smudging. So as you can see, it will probably be best to do this part first and then go back to the mountains after this step. It will definitely be better to do it the other way around than I did. Okay, so here we're gonna just put some yellow. adding some orange. We will be blending it out later, so just add some colors roughly. Gonna add some little bit of pink. And then some purple. Now we're gonna take the blue, just make a bit of green. Also gonna have to make it lighter, so we're gonna add some white. Add some white. You won't be able to actually see green in the sky, it's just more to blend it out. Won't be actually to see the green, so just gonna so we're gonna like take this green into this area right here. Using that purple so we can blend it in nicely together. Now right over here, we're going to start with the lighter blue. And then we're going to add some darker blue. And blending it into the purple night sky. see if I can add a little bit more white here to blend it in with the acrylic paint a little better. Just a little bit. Okay, now we're just going to do exactly the same again in the lake. Just go over all the acrylic that we painted earlier. So it's going to be wet paint now. So starting with the yellows. Adding a little bit of red up here. Just gonna touch up some white areas very carefully so I don't smudge everything. I love this brush for blending. It's like my favorite brush to blend. So we're just gonna blend all the colors nice and evenly in together. Just to make sure you don't make your colors too muddy. Just have a paper towel at hand, and just when you are painting and blending together, just every now and then wipe off the paint. So just very carefully around the mountains. And with a very soft hand, don't press too hard, just very softly blending all the colors together. And remember to wipe off those extra paint on a paper cloth so your brush can be clean and you can start again. So you're wiping quite vigorously. Make sure it's clean, especially if you go from the darker areas to the lighter areas. Make sure it's clean. But please, it's a dry brush. Don't wet it in turpentine or water. Just keep it dry. Smudging again. Before moving on to the stars, we're just quickly going to blend out these oil paints into the acrylic paints. Still with your nice, dry, fluffy brush, just softly blending it out into the acrylics. Just like this. Now we're moving on to the stars. We're going to use a dry brush method for this one. So make sure you have this brush. It can be a 10 or a 12. We're going to use some previously mixed colors. You can mix new ones if you like. Just going to dab your little brush into it. And then you're going to take a paper cloth. And you're gonna literally almost wipe off every paint you have on it. Let's see, it looks like this, almost nothing. And very softly, very, very softly, with a circular motion, it's just going to paint over the stars. Again, take another color, wipe it off. Don't press too hard. We don't want any brush strokes. That's also why we wipe it off on a paper cloth, because it will make brush strokes that we do not want. So very softly. And you're just gonna take some different colors. Right here we already have a little bit of yellow, pink, and then some orange. You can use different colors than I do. You don't have to do the same. You can use also a reference picture. I always have a reference picture at hand. I don't always follow it like exactly, but I always have one at hand just for in case. So you can get yourself a picture of a Milky Way and some colors and just follow that as a reference. And also if you see that the colors are a bit the same, it's probably because the colors are too light. So you can just add a little bit more color so it's a little bit more vibrant, but be careful for going too vibrant. So I just got some more colors straight out of the tube. I think it's rose pink and then magenta and indigo. Just for some more vibrant colors on the left side here. You can just really be very creative with this part, choosing your own colors, mixing your own colors, and just blending them out together. Here I use magenta. It's such a beautiful color. Just quickly switching brushes. The smaller brush is a number 6, I think. Just going to do some whiter areas. Also a dry brush. Just making some lighter areas here and there. As you can see, we are already giving some character to this painting with all the colors, creating this beautiful Milky Way and sky. I'm just gonna add a little bit more white here. So just quickly, we're going to blend out the water. Okay, so back to the mountains. I'm just going to give it another layer. But I will also be going over it with a palette knife. So of course, if you did listen to my advice earlier on the mountains, this would be the place where you'll be doing your mountain instead of where I did the first layer. And as you can see, it's a lot easier. There's no chance of smudging into the sky and ruining your lighter colors or making it muddy. So just softly, very, very softly, and also just remember to wipe off the paint on a paper cloth or towel so you don't smudge black all over your water. And then just very softly in horizontal brush strokes, you're just gonna blend them out. just quickly with a palette knife. Not too big because you will struggle. So if I have a smaller one, it's best to use a smaller one. Just mixing a dark tealish color. Well, this is basically the ultramarine blue and burnt sienna with just a touch of white. Alrighty, just dragging across a nice straight line. Okay, now we're going to switch back to the stars. By mixing white and just some of that blue we used or mixed earlier, but a very tiny amount of blue. It must be still white, just like a off-white with a hint of blue. And we're basically just gonna repeat the process of the kindergarten trick we did before, but this time it's with oil paint, so we're gonna add turpentine and not water. But with this step we're gonna just try and be more precise of where we want the stars. Be careful of big paint splotches. Just try and have more control of where your splatters will go, and you're just basically gonna repeat the whole process all over again, just with a little bit more control. As you can see, I turned my brush in my hands different directions for the stars to go in that different directions, and also I'm very close. I'm about I think 2 centimeters away, 2 to 3 centimeters away from the canvas. Now with our angle brush and lamp black straight out of the tube, we're going to draw our lines where our palm trees will be. The reason I'm using lamp black out of the tube and not as the mountains mixing my own is because I wanted to go on wet paint. So pure black out of the tube just works best to go on wet paint. So we're going to start here, moving downwards, not in a straight line, just with a curve, drag it down here, and then another one over here. And now that we have our places for our palm trees, we're just going to thicken our lines. It's a little bit more. Other one. also with the anchor grass, we're just going to draw in now where our palm tree leaves will lie. So just very carefully. It's best to have, again, to have a reference photo if you are afraid or unsure. So I'm just gonna just make lines where you want your leaves to be. They don't have to be perfect. And also don't use straight lines. I'm gonna do the same with this one. Again, they don't have to be perfect. So just making sure you have your places for your leaves where you want them. If they are too small, just make them a bit bigger and longer. You don't want the top of your palm trees to be too small, because it is your focal point of the painting, so you don't want it to look odd. Now switching to our small round brush number 4, also with the black, we're just gonna create tiny little leafies. Also don't again do straight lines. I'm just doing it over and over again. You can already see that our palm trees is getting their shape. is doing the exact same with the second palm tree. Now that we have our silhouette of our palm trees, we're going to add some green and some other colors just to give it some life. So for this, we're going to use our sap green. We're going to have our normal sap green out of the tube and then a lighter and a little bit darker color. And we also have yellow ochre right here. And this is just going to be for the stems of the palm tree. Okay, so starting off, I'm going to use my small angular brush and basically just here and there just add some sap green. You will see it's very dark, so you won't even be able to see it, but I promise you it will definitely make a difference. So just going, I don't even think you can see it on the camera. taking our lighter green. We're just going to do exactly the same, just here and there. We're going to add some lighter areas. I'm just going to do it a little bit more on the left-hand side. Just switch it up with your two different shades of the green we mixed. Also just gonna add a little bit of yellow on the most lightest areas, not all over the place, just here and there. Just add some a little bit of yellow. just taking a little bit of yellow ochre on also on the left hand side of the palm tree stem, just adding some yellow ochre. Okay, now just adding a little bit more yellow ochre, some thicker paint. Just on the very left hand side of the stem. Now moving on to the stars, guys. This is what brings the whole image together. You will see how big of a difference the stars will make. So you're gonna need a very sharp object. You can use a toothpick, a back of a small brush. I'm gonna use this needle. I find it best to work with. You're going to use the same color we used earlier for the stars, the white with the touch of blue. And you're just going to dip in your toothpick or whatever. So you're just going to dab it. And you're just going to do this all over the sky. Not too close to the mountains because they're farther away, so you won't be able to see them as much. So you're just going to dab them. Don't be careful to evenly spread out your stars because it's not gonna look natural. And basically, you're just gonna do this all throughout the sky. You're just gonna dab them. And also, you're gonna dip your object, your tool, a lot of times into the paint. You can probably do two or three stars before you're gonna have to dip it in the paint again. So just be patient and enjoy the process, because the process is also fun, not always just the end product. So just enjoy. So you can see how the sky is coming along very nicely, very beautiful. Just make sure you have bigger ones and a little bit smaller ones. You can even use different tools if you'd like. Okay, quickly switching out to a very small brush. I think this is a, I don't know, a zero, even small, I don't know, but just any very small brush. Just gonna drag it down. Like a very shiny star. Then we're gonna do another one here on the right hand side, just a smaller one. And then, let's make a shooting star as well. Just gonna take this one right here. And you're just gonna take your brush and just drag it diagonal. From thick to thinner. You can do more of them if you want. Take another star here. My angular brush just blending out some of the stars closer to the mountain. Now we're just gonna take again our small round brush. And we're just gonna drag a horizontal line here underneath the mountains. And then I'm just gonna add very plain details to the water. You can add more or less. And then just finally, just gonna take our bigger brush, blending it out a little bit. You're almost done. And here we have our final results, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you tried this, tag me on Instagram or send me photos on DM. I would really love to see your paintings. And thank you so, so much for watching. Thank you so much, Felix, for this amazing opportunity. I really enjoyed it. And I hope you guys have a wonderful day. God bless.